Here's a kit a ton of you have wanted to see inside of. So what I'm going to be doing is there is so many parts in this kit, and we'll get to what it is in a second, that I have to do a full unboxing first before I even start building it, because the unboxing is going to be a three-part video. So sit back and enjoy while I open up A&N Model Trucks Power W Pickup Truck 2500 Full Resin Kit 1/24th Scale. They have to call it a Power W Pickup Truck 2500. We all know what it really is. They just don't want to pay for the license, and I don't blame them. Dodge Ram Power Wagon 2500 3/4 ton series four-wheel drive truck in kit form. It is massive. They sent it over from the folks at A&N Model Trucks in the Ukraine. Let's take a look at all the stuff that's in the box, and there is a lot of stuff in the box, so we'll get to it. In fact, they sent over the engine kit and the enhanced suspension kit for this kit as well. So these are going to be two separate unboxings once we're done looking at all the parts in the standard kit itself. So let's get that out of the way. We'll open those in a minute. First, let's get the clear parts out so you can take a look at all your options. Now, most of this kit is in resin, and we've got some photo etch, but check out like the light detail on this kit in clear resin. Now, with a resin kit, you're going to have to cut things free from their casting blocks and sand them down just to make sure that the profiles are right. Resin, full resin kits are more of a craftsman's kit. You're going to have to do some fitting. You're going to have to do body cleanup. You're going to have to do a little extra work than just slapping it together. Look at those marker lights for the top of the cab. That's just nuts. You also want to clean the resin parts by soaking them in Simple Green or Super Clean or any generic degreaser cleaner. Don't do that with these clear parts, though. You don't want to mar them. There's your headlights. But you want to clean off all the parts so that glue will adhere. Also, when speaking of glue, model glue is not going to fit. Here's the side windows. I don't want to scratch them. They're made out of a thick, or not a thick, but a stiff, clear plastic. And the windshield is made out of a flexible Lexan polycarbonate style glass. You'll cut that out. You can see that's nice and thin and crystal clear. You'll have to cut that out to shape and glue it in place. Model cement will not work on resin parts because they're not polystyrene, so they won't melt together. You'll have to use super glue and 5-minute epoxy. Let's get some more stuff out here. They do include full decals. They include full photo etch sets for the kit for super fine detail. And they even include seatbelt material for all the seatbelts in the truck. I mean, it's just absolutely outstanding workmanship, materials. Look at that photo etch grill on there. We got all different parts of the frame. We got lettering. We got seatbelt parts. We've got, check this out, check this out. Get in between my fat fingers. Little, tiny seatbelt frames and buckles. That's not it. Printed, photo-etched parts with navigation, dashboards, surrounds, navigation, I mean, come on. That is thinking of everything. This is usually the only level of detail that the aircraft guys get, and A&N puts it in a model truck. Nice decal set, black decals for the Power Wagon. We got Hemi logos, Ram logos, Dodge logos for steering wheels and everything. Excellent set of water slide decals, and they are, looks like there are standard water slides, so just use warm water and get them out. They do, of course, include a manual. There's no way you'd be able to build this without a manual. It is colored. It's for a small run company, meaning they're not a giant Revell, they're not a Mobius and all that. Look at the attention to detail they go through. They really make it sweet. Now, I'm going to link below where you can get these. They do take a while to come in. They are coming from Eastern Europe. So right now with shipping, just be patient, but they do arrive and they are packed so nicely. Look at the transmission. We're not going to go through every teeny tiny part, but we're going to let you see all the parts in the kit. I put them in these little containers because it makes them easier to sort through for the video. Look at the detail on that dashboard. This is resin casting at its finest. I mean, this company really knows what they're doing. They've told me they've got other kits coming out that they're going to send for look-sees. Look at that differential in the back end. The front differential right down to the bolts. The steering knuckles. Exquisite resin transfer case. Get yourself a couple tubes of super glue. Inner wheel wells. Just, I'm in awe of this thing when I started unwrapping it. Here is the engine bottom. If you buy this just the standard kit, which is what we're showing right now, you will have a curbside kit. So this is the bottom of that, like we did on the Nova build. We got frame rail supports. We've got different detail and accent parts on the kit. I mean, every part that's on the real thing. Look at this. The grab handles that are on the side moldings of the interior. Now with resin kits, you will get these little bits of flash from the mold. You just take your knife, you swipe those off. They also break off really easy. But that is extremely common of resin kits. Let's get some more parts out here. Check out the tires. Just paint these with a pavement color or a Tamiya rubber. Toyo Open Country MT tires. Full branded, both sides. Completely lettered. Look at the tread pattern. Oh, delicious. I mean, they got the tires right. They got the wheels right. Those Mopar wheels. They've got inners and outers, and they just press inside the tires. It's just a press fit. A little bit of super glue will hold it in place. Check out the box molding. Just like the real thing. I like that it's all in one piece here with just the sides going on. We know it's going to build straight that way. Check out the bumper. See, like this kind of stuff, you'll have to clip off, sand that, or slice that off. It's not a big deal. Even got the trailer hookups mounted on there. And it's molded in this nice gray so you can see all the detail. Look at that front bumper cover with opening for the winch, lights. This is a customizer's dream. Look at the bed rails on this thing. All the storage boxes, like in the Power Wagon. Beautiful mold lines, fender flares, gives you nice lineup grooves. I mean, these guys are phenomenal. You should see all the other kits on their website as well when I link to that site. I mean, even where the taillights mount in looks like the real thing. Even though you'll never really see it, it looks just like the real thing. Check out that Ram hood. We all know the Ram hoods. I'm not seeing any pinholes. A lot of times in resin castings, they'll have pinholes and screw-ups on the parts. This one's not showing anything of that. I haven't seen any short shots yet, which is something that isn't cast all the way, and they throw it in the box and go, well, that's the buyer's problem. Look at the side steps. They don't look that nice on the real thing. Usually they rust out after week one. We got body moldings. I mean, even to go as far as to include that little lip there on the real thing with the door seams and the panel seams in it. We got our frame rails here. Everywhere there's a mark or a bolt or a cross member on the real thing. These guys must have gotten a hold of a Ram or production blueprints. But these are your beautiful frame rails. We got exhausts. We got drive shafts. Got a tubular exhaust molded one piece in resin with the seams and everything. We got our radiator. Awesome texture. Radiator surround. Check it out, the door panels. Oh, speakers, door panels, storage compartments molded in. Seat, the center seats. What else we got going in here? We got consoles. Oh, this is just so cool. It's like Christmas. Look at that back seat. Front seats. One huge piece of resin, and it's molded perfectly. I don't know if they mold these with pressure or what. Look at that center console. You can put your Coca-Cola, put your Pepsi in there, put your Taste Freeze. It's going to be so, so detailed of a build. We've got more. We're not done. We got more exhaust parts. This is just an entire bag of hodgepodge parts. We got our brake system, wheel hubs. We've got little frame parts on their slugs that you have to cut free. We've got our shock spring system, our coils, beautifully detailed. We've got linkages for those front drivetrain, trailing arms, suspension arms. We've got little emissions equipment or pumps or coil. There's just so much stuff to go through. Check out the lettering on that. MAR. RAM. Rear view mirror. Oh, this gets me so excited just looking at all these little pieces and parts. Check out all the little shackles and equipment. Like I said, these are craftsman's kits. You're going to have to do some cleaning up. We got our steering wheel here. Spot on to the real thing. I mean, these guys are amazing. There's your pedals. Check these out. Look at all these bolts. All the way across there. I mean, this kit would be cool if you're just a kit collector for this level of craftsmanship in a model like this. All right, so those are all the small parts in the kit. Now look at that. Look at that. The biggest piece in the box, the huge cab assembly. Of course, you could always cut the doors open on a kit like this. That RAM grill. I mean, just look at that. Now you'll have to go through and clean, see how it is when they mold it. You get these inserts from the glass. So you just take your knife. They just carve really easy. You can see, not like it's hard. It just pierces it. It's not a difficult thing to do to slice that out. You have a good razor knife. Sunroof, back glass, back of the cab detailed. And that is a nice size kit, 1/24. Power Wagon's a big truck. 1/24. They got nice locators for the lights, like the real thing. The little bump ups. Stiffening ribs on the roof. And we got our floor plan. All interior, you can get that all painted up. Underneath looks like the real thing. So that is all the stuff that's just in the basic kit. I'm going to take out the engine and the suspension, let you look at the enhancements. Those hungry for even more detail on their kit will want to buy the enhancements. This one is the suspension we'll look at first. Molded individual coil springs with rubber stoppers on the top and bottom. Look at that, in their own little package, so we don't want to take those out because those are fragile. So we don't want to take them out until we're actually going to build. Another set of photo etch to work on your suspension. And super, finely molded details, sway bar links, steering links. Check this out. Pulled one free from its casting plug. Look at that little part. That is absolutely outstanding. The rest are molded on here. You'll just cut them free, gently. Use a brand new hobby knife when you're working on these kits. And when you sand any parts, just keep them wet sanded so that you don't get resin dust in the air. Or wear a respirator mask, as always recommended when you're going to be sanding a lot on resin. You got little shocks or a little steering shock. I mean, this is just flipping awesome. The manual for it, unlike additional kits you'll find from other manufacturers, again, tells you exactly what to do with the photo etch, how to bend it, where to insert the enhancements on the factory kit with your skid plates and everything underneath. Tells you exactly how to work with it. In color, highlighting the part you're going to use so that you never get confused. Now let's switch over and get the engine out of the box. Last, but a billion times not least, the gorgeous 6.4 liter Hemi that goes under the hood of that massive Dodge as a kit in and of itself. In fact, if you built that, you might want to just set it on the side and say, this is a curbside truck and this is what goes under the hood so you can see all the detail. Let's just get some of the small stuff out. The engine cover alone is spectacular. Even got the little oil filler on the side. We got our front pulleys, engine cover. We got cylinder heads, valve covers. Super crisp detail. We've even got the cowl for over the radiator since it would be a curbside otherwise. We've got batteries that'll fit in underneath the hood. We've got air boxes, master cylinder. Ooh, so little. Looks awesome. We've got AC lines, coolant lines. Look at all these little pulleys. All these little air boxes and emissions equipment and underhood. We've got all the piping and equipment to hook up the air box itself as well. Check that out. That is so awesome. We've got AC pumps, alternators. Everything on the real engine is simulated. Oil pan. Intake. And the block. I mean, it's even got the flywheel molded into the back. Block halves look exquisite. Anybody that owns a Dodge has had to work on a Dodge, so now they'll know exactly what it all looks like in miniature. You could fix the real thing. And, of course, the book will walk you through everything in full color about how to not only assemble the engine, but retrofit it, put a belt on it, retrofit it into the Dodge that you have, and add all those accessory pieces to your existing model kit. So this thing is just absolutely outstanding. It is an amazing kit. And then you get all the extra parts. And when you're done, you will have, I guarantee, the world's most detailed Power Wagon 2500 Ram truck on the planet in kit model form. The thing probably has more parts than the real truck does, you know what I'm saying? Just joking, but you know what I'm saying. So absolutely, thanks to A&N Model Trucks. Stay tuned. When I get spare time, I'll finally get able to dive into it, but I wanted to make sure we saw all the parts. You guys are anxious to see it. I wanted to get them on screen. We'll see all of you at the next review.